Hello everyone. Today I want you to introduce to our paper OmniFlow, a human omnidirectional optical flow indoor dataset. My name is Roman. I'm a PhD student at Technical University of Chemnitz, Germany, and this paper is a collaborative work with Andre and Gengolf. Optical flow is the motion of a pixel between at least two consecutive video frames and can be estimated through an end-to-end trainable convolutional neural network. In recent years, large-scale synthetic training and benchmark datasets have accelerated the development of learning-based approaches and demonstrated a way of quantitative evaluation without capturing real-world data. Especially in optical flow estimation, this plays an important role due to the high necessary effort to collect and label real-world data. Application fields of optical flow are the left image, intraoperative tracking of the retinal fundus, and activity recognition on the right-hand side. But first, a short recap. Optical flow datasets with humans in perspective views are included in datasets such as HD1K, Sintel, and Kitty with its virtual counterparts. However, these datasets lack of omnidirectional camera geometry or have a moving camera which are not appropriate to estimate humans' behavior with unknown camera parameters. To tackle these problems, we construct a fully animated 3D indoor environment with a 3D rendering engine, namely Blender. The setup of these animated scenes contains a moving human from various camera locations with static background modeled as 3D indoor environment. The simulation contains control parameters, such as variability in rooms, animations, textured characters, objects, illumination, and motion blur. Out of these, we have generated 321 scenes, each with 75 images and corresponding forward and backward flow, which leads to a dataset size of approximately 23,000 image pairs. We randomly have set control parameters to produce highly variable motions of activities such as cleaning, falling down, or sitting. To simulate realistic illumination for indoor, we randomly set two artificial light sources in each scene. For outdoor, we use high dynamic range images to simulate daytimes. The high distortion of the omnidirectional camera results to large motions where we have included motion blur. It results from a perceptible movement of the subject during the exposure time. Motion blur increases with the exposure time and the angular velocity of the subject relative to the camera. This effect helps to decrease the gap between real-world and synthetic data. But how to evaluate a dataset which has no comparable benchmark? The evaluation of the dataset was based on a pre-trained model of RAFT, a state-of-the-art 4D volumetric correspondence network with a crew unit. For this, the model was trained without and with OmniFlow and tested with test time augmentation, where the purpose of TTA is to perform random modifications to the test images. We test on 10% of OmniFlow and augment these with standard parameters such as cropping, scaling, and horizontal flipping. We have observed that 5,000 image pairs of OmniFlow are sufficient to fine-tune RAFT with synthetic omnidirectional human optical flow data. Nevertheless, we provide approximately 20,000 image pairs where CNNs based on correlation layers need more data for training. As expected, the EPE values of the flow test set with TTA, here shown in orange, are uniformly higher due to the higher variance of the augmented test set. In this work, we present OmniFlow, a 3D indoor simulation with highly variable rooms, objects, and humans, and a virtual omnidirectional camera, which records image data and flow. We evaluate our data with TTA and have explored that the amount of 5,000 images is sufficient to fine-tune RAFT on flying chairs and flying things. One of our next steps are the extension of the work to multi-human optical flow with collision avoidance.